Assalamu alaikum children. Welcome to the science class for the grade 5. This is lesson number 14, our environment part 3. In the previous two videos, we have studied about the greenhouse effect as around the earth, our atmosphere acts like a greenhouse and the gases present in the atmosphere, they protect the earth from harmful rays of the sun and it maintains the temperature on the earth. And we have also studied about the global warming, the increasing temperature on the earth, about the global warming and its effects also we have studied. And we have also solved the math following in the quick check bit. Today we will continue this lesson with the topic saving the environment. As in our environment we have natural resources which make our lives comfortable. So it's our duty to protect it, to save it and to conserve it. So let's see how to reduce global warming. To reverse or slow down global warming, we will have to make sincere efforts to remove the factors responsible for it. The factors which are increasing the global warming, like we have seen, human activities are increasing the greenhouse effect. Cars, buses and factories burn fossil fuels such as petrol, diesel or coal. So burning fossil fuels releases carbon dioxide. So more carbon dioxide means an increase in greenhouse gases. So more heat is being trapped and earth is becoming warmer due to an increase in greenhouse gases. Good. This is all about greenhouse effect and global warming we have seen. So given here are some ways by which this global warming can be reduced and we can save our environment and we can achieve this goal by following these steps. So first one is reduce air pollution. So what are the factors which are polluting the air? Smoke from factories, smoke from vehicles, burning the crackers, forest fire and burning the waste crops. These all things pollute the air. So we should reduce air pollution to save our environment. Stop using fossil fuels, as fossil fuel is a non-renewable resource. So we cannot get it if we overuse it. We cannot get it soon if we are not using it wisely. So stop using fossil fuels. Switch to renewable energy. As we have seen, fossil fuel is a non-renewable energy. So instead of that, we should use renewable energy, like we can produce energy by water and solar energy. Stop burning wood, which makes the air polluted. Conserve forest. So forests are very important to maintain the clean and green environment. So we should conserve forest. Should not cut down the trees and should plant more and more trees. Plant more trees and follow the 3 R's rule. This 3 R rule already you have studied in the previous classes. Reduce, reuse and recycle. To reduce the waste. As human beings produce lots of waste every day, so if we use this method, 3 R's method, we can reduce this waste. So let's see what is this 3 R's rule. We can help the environment by adopting the 3 R's rule in our everyday lives. First one is reduce. Buy what you need. Don't waste or throw away anything. It means unnecessary things in unnecessary packagings or which creates more waste, we should not buy that. Buy what you need. Reuse. Put old things to some other use. Give old books and clothes to someone who needs them. Instead of throwing in the garbage, we should reuse it. Recycle. Give discarded things that cannot be reused for recycling. Means broken metal glasses, or the glass items, plastic objects can be recycled to make new things. Waste paper can also be recycled. So let us all join our hands and save Earth. So by following these methods, by following these rules, we can save our environment, we can reduce the pollution, we can save our non-renewable resources if we use it wisely. If each one of us daily does our bit to conserve electricity, water and fuel, so think how much cleaner and greener our world will be. So we should conserve electricity, water, as electricity is human-made resource. But human beings, they make these resources by using natural resources. Electricity is human-made resource. But how it is produced? It is produced by water or by solar energy. Okay. So by using natural resources, we are making human-made resources to make our lives comfortable. So for that also we have to conserve electricity, water is natural resource, fuel is natural resource. So some natural resources are renewable and some natural resources are non-renewable. So we should conserve it, we should use it wisely so that for the future generation there will be no shortage of this generation, and we can make our planet, we can make our earth cleaner and greener. Okay, children, so these are the steps which we should follow to save our environment. So that's it for today's video. In the next video, we will discuss about conservation of forest and conservation of wildlife. Till then, take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.